Brother Malcolm. Brother Malcolm. He's waiting for you.
Still full of temptation. When God spoke to the devil about how faithful Job was, the devil argued that it was only God's protective hedge around him that kept him pure. Fact about it, the devil said, remove that hedge and he will curse his maker. Malcolm, your head has been removed, and I believe you will remain faithful.
Yes.
Thank you, sir. Brother Sidney, how many of these should we turn in?
500. Make it 1,000.
Yes, sir.
Brother Malcolm, this is Brother Earl. He just accepted the teaching.
Assalamu alaikum, brother.
Alaikum
salam. Yes, sir.
Brother Earl is dedicated. We need good men like him.
I'm a willing servant for the honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Okay, brothers, let's keep it busy.
Take a good look at where you live. Take a real good look at where you live. Not just where you live, but take a good look at where everybody you know lives. Right? Because I don't want you to think you just got a bad luck accident, right? Then I want you to go downtown over to Central Park West and take a good look at how he lives.
Look at how you live. You go in other communities. You've never seen a Booker T. Washington,
Big
Greenie Stone, an Italian community. You've never went to a Jewish community and seen no freaking Douglas Delicatessen. Why is everybody in this community making money but us? It's time for the black man and the black woman to stand up and take control of our lives. It's time for us to use our dollars for our reparation. We can do what everyone else can do if we become producers and if we become the masters of our own destiny. We can have wool from sheep just like anyone else, but where are our clothing stores? We can get milk from cows like anyone else, but where are our grocery stores? We need to control our dollars. We need to control our destiny. The only thing they respect is our dollars. The only thing they respect is the wealth that we give.
So called freedom that you and I are supposed to have. To be Statue of Liberty standing like this. And for you and I, it might as well be saying, stop. Don't come no further.
Yes,
this is what he'd be saying. Don't come no further.
That's right.
So what I want you to do, brothers and sisters, what I want you to do is come on down to the temple. Oh, I'm so surprised. I'm so surprised. Y'all been in church 2 hours, and you're expecting to see heaven out here, and there ain't no heaven. You're still right here on earth. Sister, why don't you come on down to the temple? Come on down to the temple, 2 o'clock, sister. Hear the truth. Hear the black man's truth. No, you can't deny it. You can't deny it. You've been down on your knees the last 2 hours, haven't you? Begging some God to help you in the hereafter. But the hereafter is right now, brother. The hereafter is here and now. Let me talk to you for 1 second, brother. Now, listen to me. I know you're a smart man. I can tell you're a wise man. You look good. Now, you're in here in this church every day. You're in here praying to this God. I'm telling you, these so-called white Christians, they're hanging out black Christians from trees, brother. This is the man that hates you. He tells you he loves you, but he doesn't do anything for you. He tells you to foam at the mouth. He tells you to faint and sing and shout and hope for something in the hereafter. We can have it right now, brother. We can have it right now. Come on down, 2 o'clock.
I'll see you later.
Salaam alaikum. You know what that means, brother? That means peace be unto you.
Now, we have two children, little Carla, who's 2.5 years old.
Now, don't be ashamed when I call you black, because that's what you are. You're
also
black.
My mother lives
you're black and you're beautiful, because black is beautiful. Now, you know, you don't have to come down here every day begging these folks for a job. Well, you can wash their clothes for them, you can scrub their floors, you can rock their little brats to sleep for the rest of your life. You'll still end up poor and without anything. And yet you're out here on the auction block. They're examining you like you're a chicken or a horse or a slave. You see this here? This is who you are. Beautiful. Your beautiful black selves with pride and dignity. In fact,
I was expected to work one Saturday every month, and occasionally into the evening. I help my...
You see, this is what you... These are the questions. These are the questions you and I have to ask. How did we get this mind? You're not an American. You're an African who happens to be an American. You have to understand the difference. We didn't come over on the Nita, the Pinta, and the whatchamacallit. We didn't land on Plymouth Rock. Plymouth Rock landed on us, landed right on top of us. Shorty, is that you, brother? Praise be to Allah. Now, this is exactly what I'm talking about, the slave mentality, the slave mind. This brother and I, we had the slave mind. We used to rob together. We used to sleep with white women. We even went to prison together. Now, don't be surprised when I say we went to prison, because some of y'all still in prison right now. Prisons of your mind. Stand up, brother. Come on. Your brother's a little shy. Come on, brother, give me a hug. Yeah. That's all right, brother. That's all right. Look, he still got his hair fried. That's all right, though. That's the slave mind. That's the slave mind.
I got to hand it to you, Red. That's the best preacher hype ever did here.
No hype, brother. That's the truth. Why don't you come on back down to the temple and hear some more?
Man, I can't pay that no mind.
Brother, you need to pay it all your mind. What mind you have left?
Take it easy, Greasy. This is me, Shorty. Let's go around the corner.
Yes, sir. Not anymore. I've been clean for 8 years, brother.
8 years?
8 years.
You was something, homie. My trouble is I love pigs' feet and white women too much. So I damn sure can't be no Muslim.
That's because you lost, brother. That's because you lost. If we can find you.